Hi, I'm Amy with Slices of Pie, and I'm back today to talk more with you about your questions about the digital nomad lifestyle. Last time we talked, I promised I was going to give you a few tips on how to find and obtain a remote job that you could do from the road. But before I get started, I wanted to bring something up that I forgot to talk about last time, and that is the uniform. Working and living on the road means I can pretty much dress up as fancy or as casual as I want. And today, I'm sporting a few souvenirs I got from some of the fun locations we've been to. So that's a huge benefit of working for yourself and working on the road. So let's talk about how to find a remote job. I'm going to show you a couple of different websites that I used when I was looking for a job that I could do from the road. And those two websites are going to be Indeed and Craigslist. So let's jump in and take a look at them and see how you can use them to find a job that will work for you. I recommend starting with Indeed. If you've never gone on to a job searching website, you can go into indeed.com. And it's going to provide you with a lot of employers use this. Type in the word remote and then choose find jobs. This is going to be an eye-opener for you because as you can see on the left side of the screen, as we scroll down, there are a lot of jobs that are tagged remote within Indeed. You can organize them by the date posted. We looked at remote, what kind of salary estimate. The job type's gonna tell you, do you wanna work full-time, part-time, you wanna be a contractor, temporary. but you can also expand your search a little bit more by saying, I wanna look for an administrative job, for example, and find that. That's gonna narrow down the results, so you'll have jobs there. Oh, watch out for these pop-ups. If you put your email address in there, you're going to be inundated with a lot of spam mail. Anyway, let's take a look at some of the jobs that came up during this administrative remote search. So, for example, they're going to give you some information about the position, what you might need as experience, and something about the company. And as you look at these and you're looking at the job description and the experience that you need, don't be afraid to apply for something you haven't done before. If, as I described the job, it sounds like skills or things you've done or things that you could probably learn quickly, go ahead and apply for the position. You might be surprised how well your transferable skills will work into a new type of employment. I have changed jobs myself many times. You can also look on here. You'll notice there's a difference between working as a contractor or as an employee, and that'll really affect the types of benefits that are available. So if you're in a situation where you must have employer benefits, you want to look at that. Also, you can upload your resume here. You can simply register for an account by using your Google account, your Apple account, Facebook, or you can build one independently. But you will need to do that in order to actually apply for jobs on this website. So now we're going to talk a little bit about Craigslist. You probably have all logged into Craigslist, so go ahead and use the website that, you know, Craigslist.org is what you're going to look for. I happen to be in the Dallas area right now, and so I'm searching in the job section. I'm simply going to type in the word remote. Now, this was a real handy feature in the last site we saw, but as you can see, it can not be as successful on Craigslist. And you notice here, there's a lot of listings with the simple word remote. That's because everything with the word remote is showing up. You also might want to change your location. Since this is in the Dallas area, you can actually open a map and kind of hone in an area. This is especially important if you want to work for an employer that's maybe near your hometown or a place where you are going to be visiting frequently and you might want to actually have in-person contact. But you can also change your location by going into the US cities. I'm going to go to Portland here just to show you that. Go back into jobs and again I can look for remote. I can also use a telecommute option on the sidebar, and that's going to provide me with jobs where the employer has listed telecommuting as an option for that job position. You can also go back and narrow down your search, so you might want to be looking specifically for certain types of jobs rather than all jobs with the remote or telecommute tag on it. You can go back and look for remote positions like we did before. But again, you're going to get a long laundry list of jobs that show up from that search. So just be patient. Take some time when you're looking at these jobs. You might narrow it down and say work from home. That's a popular phrase that's used in some of these postings. So don't be afraid to kind of get creative and try some different ways of looking for a job on Craigslist this way. I actually found the job I'm working for now on Craigslist, so I'm a pretty big fan. Again, you want to go in and look for a specific position. You can see here there are a lot of different types of jobs. You can narrow down your search so you won't be looking at every type of remote or work from home opportunity. So those were just two websites that I personally recommend for finding a remote job. There's a lot of job seeking websites out there. In fact, you might already be registered for one. So I encourage you to log in and try some new keywords you haven't tried before, because it could reveal a lot of opportunities for you to find something that you can do from the road. Also, remember, be careful when you sign up for websites. It's going to inundate you with those emails. We talked a little bit about that. I urge you to unsubscribe from those things. They can be pretty tenacious. And the last tip I have for seeking employment, never, ever, ever accept a text interview. There's a lot of scammers out there. I received several offers while I was registered on job seeking websites where they wanted me to text interview, and a lot of that is just a phishing scam. If a person doesn't want to meet with you face to face, if you can't legitimate the job offer, do not accept it and block them from being able to text you again. This is exciting. I'm excited for you, but you need to be excited for me now. I'm going to share with you some fun adventures we have. Again, living on the road, working from the road means we get to visit new places. So I'm about ready to take you on a short adventure of what we did while we were visiting San Antonio. But make sure you stay and watch until the end of the video, because I am going to share with you an important tool you have to have if you're working from the road, and you're going to want to see it. You're going to want to hear more about that. So stay tuned and make sure you subscribe. Make sure that you ring the bell and that you give a thumbs up. And that's going to allow you to be notified when we put more content out so you can watch it and stay tuned with our adventures and keep up with all of my tips for you working on the road.
So for a holiday gift, I guess not a holiday gift, but for a gift, we bought ourselves season tickets to SeaWorld. We figured, what better than to go on Thanksgiving? And we've got about 30 mile an hour gusts. Check out the flag.
It's beautiful. We're in San Antonio.
The whole flag pole is shaking. So now we're gonna go redeem our flags, or our tickets, and see what is open. One of the few roller coasters that's actually open. And it's like one of the biggest ones, so.
We're gonna see
it, and we're gonna take you along with, because I'm gonna hold on to the camera.
You're crazy.
Yeah, I'm a little dizzy. That was the great white.
I'm gonna need a break after that.
I'm gonna need a beer. The Christmas decorations are really nice.
Yeah, they are.
So it's just a little chilly, so I think we're gonna call it a day.
Since
we have season passes, we'll be jumping around and doing this in Florida and whatnot. So
yeah, and they have Busch Gardens there.
Oh, sweet. Yeah. All right. Well, let's get out of here. So we are in San Antonio, Texas, and we are gonna go today and check out the Riverwalk and the Alamo. So, never been there before, even her. Living in Texas, never been there before. So we're gonna go and check it out and see what it looks like.
Yeah, very exciting.
We made it, here it is. And they have all these little plaques here that kind of show the evolution and the dates of when it changed.
So, like, for example, in 1785, this wall was added because of an Apache attack.
Squad, prepare to load in 12 times. Load. Open hand. Handle cartridge. Tear cartridge. Prime. Shut pan. Cast about. Charge cartridge. Draw river. Ram cartridge.
From the fire that burned their bodies rose the eternal spirit of sublime heroic sacrifice, which gave birth to an empire state. So we just boarded the Del Rio boat tour on Riverwalk in downtown San Antonio, Texas.
Right, so we're gonna float these canals and who knows where we're gonna go, but it could be interesting.
Wasn't that fun? Anyway, as I promised, I was going to share with you an important tool of working from the road, and that's going to be your Wi-Fi hotspot. Now, not all hotspots are made the same, and so in our next episode, we're going to talk about more what you need to do to get Wi-Fi on the road and what some options are for you and what some pitfalls might be. So make sure you tune in next time when we talk more about Wi-Fi on the road.